one of the reptile keepers here at the Naples Zoo, and this is Bones. And Bones is an Argentine black and white tegu. Now, guessing by his name, you can probably guess where he is from. He does live in Argentina in his native range. And they are omnivores. They like to eat a little bit of everything. They get produce and protein as well as hard-boiled eggs. Now, like I said, they are from Argentina, but they are also found here in Florida. Now, they are known as an invasive species. Now, Florida is home to the most amount of invasive reptiles and amphibians in the entire world. Now, an invasive reptile you might have heard a little more about than our tegu is a Burmese python. We're hearing a lot about them, especially because it is a little more scary to have a very, very long constrictor in your backyard. And maybe not so much about these guys, these larger lizards. But they are causing a lot of harm in our ecosystems. They are not part of our local ecosystems. They don't have a role to play in our native food chain. So they are coming in and out-competing a lot of other species, and they don't have too many natural predators, if at all, here in Florida. Now, I know that might sound a little bad, but in their native range, they do play those hugely important roles in the food chain, both as predator and as prey. So it's really important that we keep them where they belong in their native food chain, in their native ecosystems. Researchers do believe that they came here to Florida from the pet trade. Now, if you're looking at Bones here, he is pretty calm. He's very cute. He's got these chubby cheeks, which is a male trait, where the males have these big jowls, and the bigger they are, the more handsome you are. But they require a lot of work. He lives here with his brother, Sai, and they have a very large habitat in our behind the scenes area. We have like the hard boiled eggs I was talking about, but they do also eat what's known as whole prey items. So that's things like frozen rats and chicks. Now it's a pretty hard argument to make, trying to keep a bag of rats right next to your ice cream. So they can be a more intensive pet to have. So we always ask, if you want to get a pet, even if it's a cat or a dog, always make sure you do your research very well and make sure that you're able to give the animal the life that they deserve. So Bones and Sai are part of a training program where we work with them every single day. So they are socializing with us, spending one-on-one time with each other, so both us and them are really comfortable with one another. And that's another thing that takes a lot of work, that they really need that socialization. But they are extremely intelligent animals. Along with this desensitization work, they are also target trained and station trained. So when we feed them, they have a little station they go to. So they are very highly intelligent animals. They are so full of personality. And we want to leave you with the message that we have so many different amazing species of reptiles and amphibians in Florida. But we want to make sure that we keep Florida beautiful. There is an app you can download on your phone called I've Got One, and you can become a citizen scientist through that app. If you happen to see any kind of invasive plant or animal, you can snap a picture of it, and that will send it to a scientist so they can record where that plant or animal was, so they can keep really accurate records of all of that. So you can go out today, keep Florida beautiful, and
and be a scientist yourself.